morning, good afternoon. I'm going to wait till somebody comes on. Hello, hi. Hi, everybody. Welcome, 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 welcome. You're very welcome to our second of our lunchtime lives from my kitchen in Greystones. That has no heating, which is why I'm wearing my coat. So our heating broke down because, you know, 2021 was just so much fun. So, you know, the gods decided to send us a little bit more of a challenge. Hi, everybody. Hi, 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 hi. So we are making today a tomato bruschetta. Now, it's really simple, but it's actually really tasty, and it's a great little thing to have in your lunch repertoire. So I think lunches at the moment are quite a challenging meal for most people because we're not normally at home. Now, I know we've been home for a year, so many of you probably have a bit of a lunch routine going. But normally, say in the normal course of things, you would have been doing your school lunches and then whatever you were doing during the day, you'd just maybe have to fend for yourself. Or else if you were working, going into your office, you'd be obviously maybe grabbing something to eat in near your office or bringing in your own packed lunch or whatever. So now that we're all home yet again, lunches are another challenge. So that's why I'm going to focus on lunches kind of this month, and I am in the middle of writing a blog all about lunchtime lockdown lunches. So I'm hoping to have 50 ideas for you for easy lunches. I'm hoping. Anyway, to get us started, I am going to do a quick dance around the kitchen because that's what I do in all my cooking classes. So we're going to dance to Uptown Funk because it's nice and lively and it'll warm me up because I'm... Okay, Alexa, play Uptown Funk. So if you're watching me, have a jump around the kitchen with me. And if your kids are with you, do a little bit of a dance around the kitchen. Alexa, volume 10. Can you hear that?
This is that ice cold Michelle fight for that white gold. This one for them hood girls.
Them dance people.
Straight masterpieces. Styling, wilding, living it up in the city. Got chucks on with Saint Laurent. Gotta kiss myself, I'm so pretty. I'm too hot.
Alexa, off. Okay, I'm hot now. I wasn't hot earlier on, but I'm hot now. Okay, so a little bit of a dance around the kitchen to warm us up, get us moving, get us energized, and then we are going to start cooking. Not very much cooking involved in this recipe. Really simple, really straightforward. But if you've got kids at home and you're doing this with your kids, so I hope there's loads of kids watching and you're going to join in, bring them shopping and get them to help you pick out the tomatoes. Food is never endingly exciting and interesting. And there's so much to learn about food. Nobody knows everything about food. So we need to instill that excitement into our kids and bringing them shopping. Like, I got these in Lidl. Was it Lidl? Anyway, the supermarkets have a great range of tomatoes. So what I would encourage you to do is bring them shopping with you, get them to pick some lovely tomatoes, some different colors, different shapes, different sizes. And then bring them home and you can do a whole little tasting thing. So get them to see, oh, does a yellow tomato taste the same as a red tomato? And does a round tomato taste the same as a plum tomato? So it's getting them excited and interested in food in kind of a different way, rather than just getting them to sit down and eat. This is what you're having, eat this. Okay, so getting them involved. When you think about food, there is a whole industry, massive industry out there all about food. But yet our kids have such a very narrow focus on the food that they eat. So we need to engage them and get them excited and curious about food. And tomatoes is a really good place to start. So for example, I have these tomatoes that on the vine. the dancing is catching up on me. So, for example, you could get some tomatoes on the vine. Talk about where the tomatoes grow. Do they know that they grow in a like a bush or a tree? Grow your own tomatoes, of course. And then we're going to pluck one of these tomatoes off, okay? So we're going to mix the tomatoes with, I'm going to use a big plum tomato, and I'm going to use some of these little yellow tomatoes as well, just for a nice bit of colour, and some of these darker coloured tomatoes. But use whatever tomatoes you have. So we're going to chop them, just roughly chop them, and fresh basil. Oh my God, like the smell of them. So when you're using fresh herbs, a really good thing you can do with the kids is get them to put it in the palm of their hand and squash it. And then put your nose into your hand. Oh, that really, the oils in your hands releases the smell and it just smells so gorgeous. And then eat that. Okay, I'm gonna eat that. So I'm gonna use a tiny little bit of onion in this as well. Just a really small bit because I don't like lots of raw onion. But we're going to use a tiny little bit just for the flavour. So what I do, and what I've been doing in my cooking classes that I did before Christmas in a school I went into, is we looked at the tomato. Okay, so when you're making this with the kids, or if you're making it now, just chop your tomato roughly and taste it. Just taste it as is. Okay, so just chop off a piece of your tomato and have a little taste of it. Okay, give some to the kids. Oh, that's nice. Okay, then we're going to chop off another little bit. And I'm going to add a little bit of salt. Just a tiny little bit of drizzle of salt. And we'll see, does that change the flavour at all? Really intensifies the flavour. So we're going to slowly layer up the flavours here, which is what we do in the bruschetta as a whole. But with the kids, we're going to do it. We're going to isolate the tomato out of the bruschetta and do it. Just to show them that you can alter the flavour of anything really, really easily. Okay, so we've had the tomato with a little bit of salt. Now we're going to go with a little bit of salt, a little bit of pepper, and a little bit of oil. I'm using rapeseed oil. You could use, obviously, olive oil would be a perfect one for this too. So I'm just going to drizzle that with a little bit of olive oil and taste that. Those flavors are building all the time. So when we think about cooking, you're always putting different flavors together. You start with your very basic ingredients, which in this case is the tomato, and then you're adding in flavors. So that's what makes cooking and food so exciting, how you can change the food based on whatever flavors you use. Okay, so the last one I'm gonna do is I'm gonna do same again. So another layer of flavor is going to be the basil. So a little bit of tomato, a bit of pepper. It's really a bit of a food education class, guys, but you're two for the price of one, even though you're not even paying for this, but anyway, that's the crack. That's what we all have to do in it together. Okay, so now I've got my tomato with a little bit of oil, a little bit of salt and pepper, a little bit of fresh basil. Lovely. Those simple little additions that we've made to the tomato have elevated the tomato to a whole nother place. Okay, shut up talking and get on with the chopping. Okay, so I'm just gonna roughly chop these tomatoes. Da, da, da. Up down bunk. How is the homeschool going? Homeschooling going? Isn't it just a joy? Actually, it's not too bad this time. I find that the schools are much more organized, certainly for my kids anyway, My poor teenager is up there. He hasn't left the room since Monday. His class is aplenty. Okay, so I'm going to chop in some yellow tomatoes as well. I don't know if you can see. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to put them in a separate bowl. And then I am going to add the flavour to it. And let them sit for a little minute. Now guys, this is really easy. So I'm all about easy lunches, easy family food that doesn't take too long, doesn't require loads of ingredients. Because at lunchtime you're going to be, maybe if you're working from home and you're homeschooling, you're not going to have hours to stand up. What are you talking about? To stand around making a lunch. You might only have half an hour to get your lunch made and eaten. So this doesn't take long at all. So throw in another, kids love this, so I'm going to do a few more tomatoes. As I said, if you're doing this with the kids, get them to taste, if you have different coloured tomatoes, get them to taste the different colours, get them to taste the different sizes. Because a big tomato tastes different to a small tomato. You know, like I said, does a round tomato taste different to a plum tomato? So there's all my tomatoes there, ready to go. Okay, so into that, I'm just going to put a tiny, tiny, tiny amount of red onion. I'm using red onion because it's not as strong a flavour, and because of colour, it gives it a lovely colour. I'm just going to roughly chop that nice and small. Now you could put a bit of pepper into this, like bell pepper, but I'm not going to bother. So just a tiny little bit of red onion. I'm going to pop that in there. So now I'm going to add in some salt, pepper. Oh, and I forgot something. I'm going to add in a little bit of balsamic. You can add this in at the start or at the finish. I might drizzle it on the top, actually, at the end. A little bit of the oil, not too much. A little bit of drizzle of the oil. Okay. So I'm just going to let that sit for a few minutes while we get on and do the bread part. Now, if you've been following me recently on my stories, you'll know that we're doing a round the world cooking adventure. So as part of just our daily food thing, the kids are picking a country each night for us to cook from. So we have had People's Republic of Congo, which was challenging, but we got through it. We made a lovely ground nut, which is peanut and tomato curry. Last night we did, where did we do last night, guys?
China.
The kids are under the table there doing their homeschooling. So,
this is our office.
That's their office. We did China last night, so I did it was actually tasty, wasn't it, guys? We did I had no pork or chicken, so I used a bit of ham that I had that I was going to boil, and I just chopped it up fine, and I used that vegetable and ham and Chinese flavors with some noodles. Okay, so your bread is really important when you're making a bruschetta. You can't really use a slice of white bread and spread. You just can't. It just is not the same thing at all. So I've got this lovely bread. This is Firehouse Bakery bread. They are close to me, so I'm very lucky. But even if you get a baguette or a ciabatta, will be great.
Ciabatta
is the type of Italian bread. So what I'm going to do with this is, you don't need to toast this, but again, toasting it elevates the flavor a little bit. And what I'm also going to do is I'm going to rub some oil and garlic onto the bread to again elevate that flavor again a little bit higher. Again, a little bit of oil. I'm just going to drizzle a little bit of oil on it, on the bread. So I'm heating up my pan as we speak. I'm just going to brush that on. Da, da, da. Wait, once the kids to do. I'm just brushing my bread with a bit of oil. Now, for any kids watching, this is a bulb of garlic. See, this is like a bulb you put in the ground. Okay, so we're gonna separate it, so you just pull it apart. And each one of these is called a, anybody know? Do you guys know what these are called? When you separate the garlic out? It's called a clove. Okay, my cooker's gone off. Oh, I don't think the electricity's gone. No, the lights are still on. We lost our electricity as well last week, like Armageddon or what. Okay, so I'm just going to take the paper off my garlic. Now, another thing you could do with this is you could actually infuse the garlic in the oil. So that just means, that's just a fancy way of saying steeping your garlic in a bit of oil. And then paint it on your bread. So I'm just going to rub the garlic on the bread, because then it's not too much garlic, but it definitely gives the taste of garlic. My cooker's after going off. I don't know what's happened. Janie Mac. I only just got this. Just stopped. Oh, there we go. I lied. Okay, so I am just going to put the bread onto a dry frying pan, face down. And I'm going to rub the other half with the garlic. So layering up the flavors all the time. Now, a bruschetta, like, it's like a sandwich. You can do this a million different ways. This is just the way I do it. I'm gonna press that down into the pan. I'm gonna let that grill away. I'm gonna get this out of the way. Da, da, da. Okay, so another exciting news, while we're waiting for that to toast a little bit. I'm going to do some live cook-alongs with other people. So, I don't know how that's gonna go, but your luck, you have to try. And my first live cook-along is going to be with Emma Jane Leeson from Johnny McGorry. So Emma Jane writes the most amazing kids' books. They're all about encouraging kids to get out in nature and spending time outside, outdoors. And she has sent me her Nana's recipe for soda bread, and I've never made soda bread, so it's perfect. So we're going to make that on Friday, and I'll send you out the recipe details, but so if you want to join in with that, that would be a great one. And we'll have chats about her books and stuff like that. And then the following week, hopefully, I'm going to be cooking with Chad Byrne, who's the head chef of the Breton Hotel down in Killarney. I'm not sure what we're going to cook yet, but he's great crack. If you ever follow him on social media, he does lots of cooking. He does lots of amazing stuff. Supporting chefs all over the country. So hopefully he's going to cook with me next week. And then the week after that, Suki from Suki's India is going to show me how to make we haven't decided yet 100%, but so we're going to do those live cook-alongs, and I'm going to do a cook-along every Wednesday, so I'll be doing two cook-alongs every week. Okay, so I could do a grilling this a little bit longer, but sure, I'm sure you all have things you have to do rather than sit here waiting for me to cook my bread. So I'm going to turn that off. Guys, do you want to get out and taste this? Okay, so there's my nice toasted bread. I'm going to top with the tomatoes. So the lovely juice of the tomatoes. Maggie, I'm so happy. Hello. Some of the fresh basil. Delicious. I'm just gonna tear that up. Jamie Oliver style, just rip it up. Put it on top. So you could serve this with an egg on the side, because we love eggs. So there's our bruschetta. I'm just gonna drizzle over some Balsamic. Ooh. That looks good. I'm gonna bring it right into the camera. Can you see that?
It's cold.
Ooh. That looks good. It's a big favorite in your house, Caroline. Yay. Okay, I have a taste, Maggie. So it's really simple, but it's just really delicious. And sometimes we forget about these kind of things. What do you think, Max?
Yummy.
Yeah. So yeah, you could serve it with, because there's no protein in that really. So you need to serve it with some kind of protein. So a piece of fish or chicken or an egg, or you could add some cheese on the top and grill that before you put the basil on. Lots of different options. So yeah, so I hope you enjoyed that. Let's see, is there any comments? Okay. So guys, thank you so much. Maggie's gone off underneath the table to finish that. And hopefully see you on Friday to make soda bread. Thanks for tuning in. Bye. No, don't do that. So, give me the phone, please.